Our final paper presentation for today before we end today's session will be presented by Mr. Wan Mazi Wan Rosali, Executive Head of ITT Services, Mustafa Negri Sarawak, with his paper entitled Library Takes Advantage of Maker Movement. Please welcome.
Being the last presenters is a big challenge because of one foot will be here and another will be in the car, isn't it? Alright, so my presentation will be looking at the overall advantage that we have taken by learning through either readings or experiencing, or by doing things. But, so that's why I put the presentation into things that we have in the library, which we can use to take advantage on the maker movement. All right, the outline of my presentation will be an explanation of what's library, Maker movement, maker spaces in library. We have it in Pustaka. Maker event worldwide. So that you will know that what am I talking about. And the next maker plan that we are going to have in Pustaka. Alright. The UNESCO Public Library Manifesto. There are 12 missions that library must focus on. But these three key missions of public library services is really close to the maker activities. So if you look at the numbers, 3, 4, 5, because number one and number two is the other two missions that the library have to fill in. But that one really based on the library services. But this one I'm going to focus on is on the maker activities or the creativity or innovations that library to have to focus on. The number three key missions is providing opportunities for personal creative development. So library must support this kind of activities by putting services, by providing spaces for these kind of activities. And number four, stimulating the imagination and creativity of children and young people. And number five, promoting awareness of cultural heritage, appreciation of the arts, scientific achievement and innovations. And the word innovation is really important here when we want to do the maker movement. So what is maker? Everybody or everyone can be a maker. So we bake cake. We make things right at home. Okay? And there's a company that makes specific products. Sony, Apple, those are makers. And the machine that makes something. Right? The bread maker, and the 3D printer, right? That's maker. Alright, what is maker movement? Maker movement is a trend now. The maker activities, people are gathering and showcase whatever they have made and show to people or sell it, right? Then what is makerspace? Makerspace is any place. You can do it at home. You can do it in the library, you can do it in school. As long as you have an activities of making things. So in libraries, we often have 3D printer, like what we have in Pusaka. We have a software, we have an electronic parts, the circuit boards. If you heard about Raspberry Pi, Arduino, SparkFun, these kind of things are maker tools or crafters. All right, maker space in the library. So, example that I have taken is from the United States of America. I've learned conducting the makerspace activities when I was there. The makerspace at public libraries, you can see the Watertown Free Public Library, Arizona Phoenix Public Library, the Library District in Colorado Springs, and Beaver Country Library. These are makerspaces. And in the academic library, there's a lot of makerspace in America. More than 80 makerspaces in the public libraries, and then more than 18 makerspaces in academic libraries. These are just some of the examples. In Westport, the makerspace is basically run by the community. The maker coach is as young as 10 years old to run the makerspace, to do a 3D printer coach. So these people learn either by reading through a digital media or reading in the books so that they can conduct the maker activities. So all those knowledge apply from whatever they have read before into the maker activities. So in Westport Library, the concept originated from the realization that the library should provide experiences that take people from imagination to actual productions. So things that we can imagine before, then we can take it in, put it into 3D modeling, and then print it on a 3D printer. So before this, probably we only print something on paper. But now we are printing something, like example, like your name tag. You can print it in 3D. All right? This is a makerspace in American Innovation Center, Taipei. So this is a 3D printer. Right, so makerspace. And this is in Pusaka. We have started in actively in August this year. And then we make known our makerspace to the public on the 13th of August by conducting or by organizing an activity called DIY Fair, supported by Lincoln Corner Resource Center of American Embassy. So we have one 3D printer here, 10 Makey Makey, and 4 3D Doodler. 3D Doodler is a 3D printer pen for you to make things in 3D. Right? So you can have a merchandise of your own. And either you sell it, or it's a gift for someone special. Alright, this is Makerspace in Pusaka. So we're conducting the 3D printing classes, a 3D Doodler class, Makey Makey class, photography and videography and graphic design. So the reason why we only put only 1 to 2% sessions on weekend because of a limited number of equipment that we have. We only have 1 3D printer. So we are waiting for another 2 or 3 3D printer, then we can have more class. Right. All right, 4 areas of makerspace in Pustaka Negeri, as I mentioned earlier. And this is 3D printing. Example of some that we have painted. So the 3D model, you can either download it from the thingiverse.com, or you can make it, or you can do a 3D modeling of your own by using Fusion 360, Autodesk. You can use Tinkercad online, and another one I forgot about. So this tool is more important. All right. So you can see this is Pustaka's logo. We never have it in 3D before. Now we print it. This is iPhone 5S casing. This is a stretchable bracelet. Library of Congress and the famous BMAX in the Big Hero 6. All right. So this is a 3D printer that we have. So 3D printer is using plastic to print and make those things. So this is what we call extruder. We'll extrude the plastic to this tiny nozzle and then print it. It takes either 3 to 4 hours to print this small size BMX. Alright? This one is 1 hour. This one is about 4 hours as well. And this one takes 2 hours. This one 15 minutes to print. So we have a lot of colors, but it's just that this machine only be able to print one color at a time. But if you are creative enough, you just buy the Palaka color and then color your BMX with whatever color that you want. Alright? So this is 3D Doodler. Doodler is a 3D pen. So there'll be a filament fill up here at the bottom of the pen, and it will extrude to this extruder. And then it is really depend on the stability of your hand to hold this big pen, and it depends on the creativity that you have learned to make things. Right? So example of this is created by my colleague, you know, the photographer with the red shirt just now. She made this Eiffel Tower from 3D Doodler. So this is a Makey Makey is a keyboard for you to control, and then plug in the USB to the computers, and then connected to the online Makey Makey apps, and then you can make sound or control the online games, right? Then the videography for beginners and photography for beginners. And then creating school libraries or makerspace? Yes, you can. You can create it at home. This doesn't require any standard size. of space. As long as you have a maker activities, and then you can do it at home, you can do it at school libraries, or you can do it as any space that you have in school, and then bring together those maker enthusiasts to the space and then guide them on how to do things. Right? Maker event throughout the world. Maker fair. Maker fair is a name which is being trademark. It's for those who want to organize a maker fair in their country, in their state, then you have to buy a license for this maker fair. So maker fair is a award-winning event that currently is really happening worldwide. All right. So Dale Daughtry, founder and CEO of Maker Media, said, "I have always believed that the most important aspect of the Maker movement is the wide range of people. So people is important to run all the Maker's activities. Young and old who are developing their talents and discovering new ways to solve interesting everyday problems, not only does making allow them to express creative freedom, it teaches foundation job skill." Alright, a lot of jobs require skills now. Okay, maker around the world. Right? So everywhere in the world. So they have a schedule from January this year up to October next year. So in Malaysia, I have attended this Maker Fair in Penang. I think Penang is the only state who does the Maker Fair since 2014. I've not heard it from any other states in Malaysia. But in USA and other Europe countries or Japan, they have a lot of Maker Fair program throughout the year. Have schools Maker Fair, mini Maker Fair, kitchen Maker Fair, and flagship Maker Fair. So those who do it outside USA, outside the Bay Area or New York, they call it mini Maker Fair. The biggest one is the Bay Area in USA. Okay, this is the Grand Maker Fair, Bay Area National, New York. The Grand Maker Fair, which is going to be in May 19 until 21st of May 19 until 21st, 2017. So if you're interested to go, please visit Traveloka or Mass Online. All right, and this is the Westport Mini Maker Fair in 2006. The School Maker Fair, Westport, Connecticut. Singapore, our neighbors, is very active in conducting maker activities. And then Penang, this year, I went to Penang Maker Fair in October. And Pustaka DIY, because we cannot use the Maker Fair because we have not purchased the license. So we conducted the DIY fair in August 2016. The participation was overwhelming. A lot of participants coming. We see the maker. Right? So those kite making, this is carpentry. So all those, they are makers. They are not people are working in the production. This is one of the Pusaka staff. So he is one of the maker. So maker can be anybody who have enthusiasts in making things. Right, the next maker plan in Pusaka, we are going to, inshallah, we are going to organized Mini Maker Fair Pusaka October 2017. So Maker Day for libraries statewide, we are going to do a roadshow to the libraries, to the shopping mall, like what we did before twice, three times already, the Maker Day to showcase our maker activities and bring back the membership to Pusaka. And then collaboration for maker program with UNIMAS, we have signed up the MOU with them. So on the computer programming activities, so one of the electronic maker that we are going to have will be the Pusaka in the box that we are going to install, propose to schools and other libraries remotely. All right, that's it. Thank you very much. I hope that everyone will have a maker in their mind and make things and then participate in our Maker Fair 2017. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Walmarty, for your presentation. I would like to invite Mr. Keith Fong once again to present the final moment of appreciation to our speaker. Please welcome. Thank you, Mr. Keith, and thank you, Mr. Wong Mansley.